Hey you spooky dudes and babes. So I'm two videos in on this channel and I'm already starting to realize that my setup needs a little bit of adjustment. Up until now, my top-down video rig has basically been this mess. Essentially just a tripod on the verge of collapse and destroying my camera at any moment, trustingly strapped to the bottom of a coffee table. This will not do it all. So today, and don't get used to this, instead of crafting or arting, I'm going to be building my own DIY top-down shooting rig. My requirements for this build are as follows. My requirements for this build are that it needs to be super sturdy, able to hold up a pretty expensive piece of video equipment without the worry of toppling over. So, in my opinion, this rules out most of the boom arm, tripod type solutions that I've seen out there. It needs to be quick and easy to set up so I don't dread rolling my camera every time I want to work on a project. This rules out using counterweights and straps, since that requires an obnoxious level of prep in my opinion. This rig also needs to be collapsible or at least easy to break down, since my space is at a premium, and this rules out most of the frame type solutions that I've seen. And finally, of course, it needs to be reasonably cost effective. I'm not trying to spend more than my camera cost on the thing that holds it up. And with all of that in mind, I think I've arrived at a pretty good top-down video solution that meets all of my requirements reasonably well, at least really better than any of the off-the-shelf solutions that I've seen in one single package. To build this rig, I picked up some of these half-inch pipe pieces from the hardware store. If you want to save a little money, plastic pipes would probably work fine, but the metal ones will weigh the whole thing down better, and I think it will also look a little nicer. I got this long piece of pipe that's a little less than the width of my work table for the spine of the build. Two pieces of equal length pipe are for the vertical part of the legs, a couple 90 degree couplers, and for the base of each leg, I got a couple shorter pieces of pipe. 90 degree male to female couplers for each end, a T whatever thing, and two of these kind of overpriced round end pieces. The assembly of this is actually pretty easy since everything just screws together. However, the order of assembly is somewhat important to make the build process a bit more efficient. The first step is to screw those 90 degree female to female couplers to the long central pipe. These won't ever come off once they're on, and of all the connections, this is the one I don't want spinning around since it will be holding up an expensive piece of video equipment. So I make sure to get these screwed on as tight as possible, being mindful that they should be rotated to the same angle so the legs will be even and stable when they get attached. Temporarily screwing in the shorter leg pieces to get some leverage can help quite a bit to tighten these up and align them. Next, I put the feet together by screwing two of the shortest pipe pieces into one of those T's and capping each side with a male to female 90 degree coupler and a foot circle thing. Obviously, I do this twice. These pieces can also be pretty tight since I don't intend on disassembling these feet in the future. To finish the frame, I just screw a vertical leg pipe onto each end of the central pipe and then screw one of the feet we made onto the bottom of each leg. The legs themselves are screwed in securely but loose enough so I can take them off easily for storage or transport. And that's it for the frame of the rig. It's a super simple and effective design, easy to take apart, super sturdy, and like I mentioned, you could likely get away with using plastic pipes for this and probably save a decent amount of money, but this rig is sturdy enough to hold my weight, so I'm pretty confident in its ability to hold a camera. Plus, the weight of the metal means it shouldn't ever need additional weight to keep it from falling over. Maybe a hybrid approach would work too, just using metal for the feet to give it some weight. Speaking of the camera, now I need to mount that to the frame. For this, I have this tripod ball head and one of those small rig super clamps. These clamps have screw holes that fit most standard tripod heads, so I just screw these together. I was also a little skeptical about how sturdy this clamp would be, but once I tighten it on the frame, I can tell it isn't going anywhere. These clamps are pretty awesome. Now, let's test it with the camera. I think that'll be just fine. The other nice thing about this type of rig versus a boom arm, C-stand, or tripod, at least for my uses, is with more of those clamps, I can even attach a couple little LED lights right to the frame. So now I have a self-contained little top-down filming setup. Obviously, there's no such thing as a one-size-fits-all solution, but I think if you're trying to film drawing, painting, crafting, product reviews, even certain cooking-related videos, this is a pretty awesome solution. Well, my lovely spooky friends, that's my DIY top-down video setup. I'd love to hear about anyone else's solutions to this, so definitely let me know in the comments if you do any kind of top-down video and how you set that up. And of course, subscribe, bell, like, comment, share, lunch, snacks. Okay, bye.